He Xiao go forward on his horse and called out to Chu Xiao softly. General, He Xiao is here. Chu Xiao turned around. He Xiao was close to her, to the point where he was seemingly able to detect her state of trance. He felt his heart act as he felt for her. As they interacted with each other over all these years, he no longer believed the young lady's ability blindly. Over these 2 years, he had seen a lot. He had seen her when her speed was down in the doldrums. He had seen her tears, her moments of weakness, and when she felt lost. She was not the living legend who not tasted defeat in battle. She seemed more like an ordinary young lady who had stubbornly taken the responsibilities of the entire world onto her shoulder. Even when she cried, she had to hide in a corner where nobody was able to see her. However, despite this, his loyalty towards her did not waver. They had bonded in a more complex way. He was more like a family member, an elder brother, a subordinate, and a confidant. Indeed, He Xiao was still with her. The Xiu Li army was still with her. She was not without help. But before long, from the direction of the Yamin Pass came a large cloud of dust. Scout rushed back, reporting, "Master, about 10 kilometers away, 14th Prince Yuan Yang of Wei Imperial has led a force of 100,000 strong and is heading our way. As long as we live long in Pass, we will surely be ambushed." At this moment, Chu Xiao almost wanted to laugh out loud, saying that, Yanshun, what an amazing move you just pulled on me to open the pass and let her through. He had not wasted a single soldier. Using civilians to slow her down, he completely destroyed her advantage of speed. Using Wei force, he blocked off her path. Even if the Wei Emperor suspected that something was amiss, they could not afford to risk letting a Yanbei military leaders like Chu Xiao enter their borders. Even if they knew that Yanshun might be plotting something, this battle could not be avoided. Perhaps in small battles, Chu Xiao could make use of tactics and strategy to defeat Yanshun. But when it came to calculating other people and to play force against each other, she could never match up to Yanshun. The citizens had also noticed the flying dust in the distance, and fear started to spread in the crowd. Although many were full of confidence, after all, Master Chu was around yet. When they logically thought about the army of the Wei Emperor fighting with the Xiu Li army of barely 5,000, they started to hesitate. He Xiao returned to the foot of Longyin Pass. Some of his soldiers shouted, "Garrison, please open the gates for the civilians to enter." Only after shouting 3 times, a carefree voice replied to them, "Orders from the Emperor. If they wish to enter the city, Xiu Li army must enter first." The Wei army is arriving soon. Please let the civilians in. The soldiers said again. Master, what should we do? There were civilians who started to utter in panic. Terrified by the atmosphere, children started to cry as the scene descended into a cacophonic chaos. Zhu Xiao thinking that, Yan Shun, so this is what you desired. Looking up at the sky, even the last bite of hope she had for him was crushed. What do you hope to see? That I am alone without help? That I am surrounded by enemies? That I would helplessly escape, miserable to return to you for help? Yan Shun, you underestimate me. Sitting atop her horse, Zhu Xiao started her speech as she stretched out her hand to mute the bustling. With a deep, serious tone, she continued, Warriors, you have already witnessed all that has happened in recent days. Our king, the emperor of Yanbei, abandoned his past promises and betrayed the words we had sworn before the Yanbei lands and Huihui mountains. Civilians in Chang'in became nothing more than skeleton and food for the vulture, and Datong is being massacred by a force that was only loyal to His Majesty. Master Wu is dead, Lady Yu is dead, Princess Huan Huan is dead, General Xiao He is dead, General Bei Chang is dead, General Shirui is dead, General Adu is dead. All of them were killed by an ambitious man who merely wishes to expand his empire and consolidate his power. Right now, a guilt tone hangs over our heads. Warriors, before you is a 100,000 strong Wei army waiting for us, ready to finish us. Behind us is the Yanbei army that have already started to rot. They have redyed themselves to spit on us. The moment we head back and tell us that we are cowards. Beside us, there are civilians who have been abandoned by their country. Warriors, what should we do? Her cold, emotionless voice was the only sound that could be heard in the vast plain. No one spoke, and all merely gazed upon her figure with the fanatical favor. Zhu Xiao jumped off her horse, pointing at the soldiers. She shouted, Are we going to head back and become a slave to a dictator and be ridiculed by these betrayers who turned back on their promises? Or we are going to abandon these civilians and try to escape? Are we going to face off with an enemy that numbers more than 20 times of us and display the pride and honor that a soldier should have? Zhu Xiao roared, Warriors, do you want to leave? Yes, voices of soldiers and civilians replied to her in a below roar. Do you wish to become betrayers? No, again the voice of soldiers and civilians replied. Between death and betrayal, what is your choice? The crowds screamed back in maddened roar, loyalty to Da Tong, even in death. Facing the wind, Zhu Xiao yelled, Warriors, comrades, follow me, obey me. Even if we are to die, we will use our blood to give up the final spark of glory for the tongue. Our head can roll, our blood can flow, but our faith must never be unhallowed. Long live Yan Wei, long live the tongue, long live our freedom. Thank you for literally being there for me and subscribing my YouTube channel. To the people that watch even just for a few seconds, that click means a lot. See you guys in the next one. Thank you.